The littlest victims of crime find their voices to tell. Social workers have seen it all when it comes to child abuse, from sexual to physical assault to the most common, neglect. But the first step to stopping it can be the hardest, getting a child to open up. Tonight, we are advocating for all those children out there, those who need some outlet to speak up. THV's Pam Bacom helps us put crime in focus.
Scenic, warm, and inviting. The calm atmosphere on the outside leads to what goes on inside.
This is something that they have in their everyday life. At school, they paint, and they draw, and they color.
Janice McCutcheon is the director of the Cooper Anthony Mercy Child Advocacy Center in Hot Springs. This is how she starts the conversation with kids who may be abused.
My name is Janice McCutcheon, and I'm here to talk to you. I talk to kids all the time about lots of different things. This is a safe place, and that's how we would start.
McCutcheon and Tracy Childress are forensic interviewers. They're not the police. They want to send a message to kids who are being abused.
They should talk to someone that they trust, whether that's a family member, a parent, a teacher.
The next step is the interview.
Rooms are equipped with cameras. There's cameras in the room. There's also the ability to hear. We have an observation room. Say I'm interviewing a little girl and she tells me her name's Amy, and she tells me she's 5 years old. And if she told me she lived with her mommy, I would put her mommy down and whomever else lives in the home with her. And I would keep track of that on the board. And then as I'm talking with this child, when she makes reference and refers back to individuals, I know exactly who she's referring to.
Then kids can use the therapy room filled with toys and books to help them deal with feelings of hurt or anger.
We also have a little dollhouse here. This is my room, and this is what happened in my room.
Marcy Herman handles medical exams if needed. Sometimes she uses Mr. Pink Monkey to show kids it doesn't hurt.
Just a head-to-toe checkup, so I'll explain to the child we're going to start at the top of their head. We're going to work our way down.
Just like going to the doctor, the nurse and interviewers try to make the experience easy and not as stressful. But 20 years ago, the state didn't have centers like these.
Coming up at 10, we'll explain how far we've come as a state in the last 20 years. Before, children had to retell their traumatizing stories to several people and departments. These centers have revolutionized the process. You'll also learn why these centers have built-in protocols on how they speak to children.
All right, Pam, thank you. There are 13 child advocacy centers around the state. The center in Hot Springs that Pam visited conducted 50 forensic interviews last month alone. Tonight on the THV 10 o'clock difference, Max Siegel is taking us to UAMS, where they are about to begin breakthrough research on child sexual abuse, how doctors are studying adolescent girls' brains to see what treatment will best help them heal.
And good evening. Thank you for joining us. I am Craig.